Welcome, my dear friends. Myself, Mrs. Mihalaya, Head Department of Computer Science. Currently working as Assistant Professor in the subject Computer Science, Rampet Ambedkar Memorial Science College, Nagpur. In the previous video, we have seen what is data structure, how we can define a data structure, then what are the different types of data structure, which we have seen earlier. Now, in brief, we have seen what is stack, what is queue, and what is linked list. So basically, there are two types of data structure. First one is linear data structure, and another one is non-linear data structure. In linear data structure, data is always stored in the linear way. Linear way means in the continuous way. There is no gap between the two elements which are stored in any specific structure. And non-linear means the memory is non-consecutive way. So in this video, we have seen the detail of linear data structure like stack. So these are the three types of linear data structure: stack, queue, and linked list. So what is stack? Stack is nothing but a linear order collection of data elements, means the elements which are stored in the memory is in linear order or is in linear way. Then there are two preliminary operations performed on the stack. First one is insertion and second one is deletion, and both the operations are performed with only one end, and that end is called as a top end. The process of inserting new element in the stack is called as push, and the process of deleting an element from the stack is called as pop. The push and pop, these are the terminologies which we have used in data structure for only stack. For queue and the remaining other data structure, we are not using these terminologies for insertion and deletion as push and pop. The condition of overflow is occur in push. How the condition of overflow is occur, we will see in our next slide. Then the representation of stack, how the stack is represented in memory. So there are basically two types of representation of stack. First one is array. Stack can be represented as an array, and another way is stack can be represented as a linear linked list. So this is the structure of stack. We have seen this is a stack. This portion is called as a bottom end, and this portion is called as top end. In this stack, stack is nothing but it is same as the array. The difference between stack and array is that it is very difficult to insert the element in the middle or at the specific position in the array, and in the stack we can insert the element easily at the middle with the help of the pointer. But the remaining structure is same. This end is called as pop end. Here you have seen the arrow on the arrow goes upward, means the process of deletion or deleting the element from the stack, and here the process of insertion or inserting new element in the stack. Both the operations are performed with only one end, and that end is called as top. Here top, I have defined the value of top is equal to 7. How I can define the value of top is equal to 7? So 7, see, in this stack, how many elements are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So as if the number of elements which you can store in the stack is nothing but the value of top. You can, in another way, you can say it as top is nothing but the maximum value of the stack. Stack can be implemented as array, structure, pointer, and linked list. Then the operations which perform on the stack, as I have already discussed or told you how many operations are performed on the stack. So basically, preliminary two operations are performed on the stack. First one is push. Push is nothing but the process of inserting new element in the stack. So before performing this push operation, first we have seen whether your stack is full or not. What is the procedure of inserting new element in the stack? Before discussing the steps which are performed in the stack, I will just give you one example to you. The process of insertion means the push operation. For example, one tap is there and 1 liter bucket is there. And the bucket is under the tap and the tap is now on, means the water is flowing down into the bucket. So what is the capacity of the bucket? The capacity of the bucket is 1 liter only. And if the capacity is full, the water is overflow. So in the data structure, the stack is working as a bucket and the water is working as the data element which are stored in the stack. So I just explained the same thing to you. When the bucket is full and if you are trying to insert more water into the bucket is overflow. The same condition is happen with the stack. If your stack is full, means the value of top is equal to max of stack, and still any user are trying to perform the insertion operation on the stack, the condition of overflow will be occur. So that's why in the push operation, before inserting new element in the stack, first we have checked what is the value of max of stack and whether the value of top is equal to max of stack. Now what is the first step? In the first step, checks if the stack is full, means whether the value of top is max of stack. If your stack is full, means as I have already told you, there is no scope to insert a new element, means it produces error and exit, and the condition of overflow will be occur. In another case, means if your stack is not full, means there is a chance to insert a new element in the stack. It will help to increment the value of top end one by one as if we are adding new element in the stack. Once newly added element is stored on the top end location of the given stack. So this is the simple procedure which we have followed to perform the push operation. Now this is the example of push operation. In first figure, you have seen how many elements are stored. 4 elements are stored, means here the value of top is equal to 4. Now see here, the number 55 is trying to add in the stack. So after performing here, we have assumed that the value of top is not equal to max of stack, means the stack is not full. Means in another way, you can say that there is a scope to insert a new element in the stack. So after inserting new element in the stack, the structure of stack is look like this. So here previously before insertion, 4 elements are there. After insertion, now 5 elements are there. Means you can say that whenever we are performing push operation or the operation of insertion performed on the stack, the value of top will be increased by 1. That is top equal to top plus 1. So this is the algorithm or the pseudocode which we have used for the push algorithm. push is the name of the procedure. Then these are the arguments or the elements which are stored or which can be placed in the parentheses are called as parameter or the arguments which we have used in our algorithm of inserting new element in the stack. So top is one argument, first argument. Then max of stack, by mistake A is missed here. Then stack and then item. So in the first step, if top is equal to max of stack, as I have already discussed with you, if the value of top is equal to max of stack, means there is no scope to insert a new element in the stack, the condition of overflow will be occur. If the condition is false, means there is scope to insert a new element in the stack, the value of top is increased by 1, that is top equal to top plus 1, and set stack of top equal to item, means whatever the data elements or the atom which you are trying to insert at the top position of the stack, that element is stored always on the top position. And stack, here stack is nothing but working as an array. Just we have declared the array like A of I. So here we have declared stack of top, means the newly added item is stored on the topmost position of the stack and then exit. So this is the simple algorithm of pushing new element in the stack. Then another operation, preliminary operation of stack is pop. So pop is exactly opposite to the stack. In a pop push operation, we have checked the condition of top is equal to max of stack, and in pop operation, we have checked whether your stack is empty or null or not. So in the first diagram shows you the stack before deletion. So before deletion, here 5 elements are there, and after deleting one element, that is 55 from the stack, your stack is look like this, like in the second figure. So 4 elements are there, and the operation is performed with one end, and that end is called as pop. So in short, we can say that in the pop operation, the value of top will be decreased by 1. Okay, means top is equal to top minus 1. Here we have delete an element 55, top equal to top minus 1. If you want to delete 45 from the stack, again top equal to top minus 1, likewise. So this is the algorithm of pop operation. As I have already discussed one example with you, the comparison of stack with a bucket of water, similar to the push operation, I'll explain the same example for the pop operation, why the condition of overflow will be occur. The same example I will discuss here. The bucket of 1 liter water is placed under a tap. Here, in case of pop operation, initially, for example, the bucket is empty and I want some water from the bucket. If bucket is empty, so there is no scope to take some water or to pull some water from the bucket. So the condition of underflow will be occur. How? Means if your bucket is empty, there is no scope for me to take a water from the bucket. But if your bucket is full, then you can easily take the water from the bucket. So here, empty bucket is nothing but null. So that's why in step 1, if top is equal to null, then we can print underflow. Means there is no element is stored in the stack. Your stack is empty and still you are trying to pulling the element or copying the element from the stack, the condition of underflow will be occur and exit. Else is nothing but here we have initially checked whether top is null, and if top is not null, so you can delete the item easily from the stack. Set item is equal to stack of top. Here again, item which you want to delete from the stack is deleted from which end? That end is called as a top end. This step is exactly opposite to the step which we have seen in the push. In the push operation, we have set here stack of top equal to item. Why? Because the inserted item can be directly placed at the top end. But while the performing the deletion operation, the item which you want to delete from the stack, you have to sometimes specify the location of the item. So that's why item is equal to stack of top. After deleting item from the stack, the value of top is decreased by 1. That is top equal to top minus 1. Now next is the representation of array. As we have already discussed, if the stack is represented in the form of array, so this is the structure of stack. The element which is stored at the bottom means the element which is stored at first position is here. Likewise, so this is the structure or array representation of stack. This is the link representation of stack. Every element which is stored in the stack is divided into two parts. First part is information and second part is the address field. Okay, and this is called as node. And the nodes are maintained in non-continuously in the memory. Each node contains a pointer. You have seen the pointer of the next node is connected to the first node. Here again the pointer is connected to the node. Here again the next pointer is connected to the node. So the structure of the linked list is nothing but it is the collection or the combination of multiple nodes stored at one place. So these are some previous year question paper based on the topic. Define how you can define a stack. Explain memory representation of stack means array representation and linked list representation. Then algorithm which we have already discussed like push and pop, and which are the preliminary operations performed on the stack. So this is all about the stack. In my next video, I'll share the video with the concept of queue, like a stack. If you have any doubt, then you can type your question. Okay, and do not forget, if you like my video, to share and subscribe. Thank you.